Teams, please line up and step in front of your respective benches. Good evening. Welcome to Montverde Academy for tonight's feature match between host SEMA Gold and Canada's U23s. Montverde Academy promotes good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators, and requests your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, and/or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. Thank you for your cooperation. Before we introduce today's starting lineups, let's meet the officials. The referee is Daniel Gutierrez. His assistant referees are Alexander DeRostang and Abdul Kataney. And now the starting lineup for the U23 Canadian national team. Defender number 2, Caden Chung. Midfielder number 4, Matthew Schwinier. Midfielder number 6, Shamit Shone. Midfielder number 12, Alfonso Davies. Midfielder number 14, Aiden Daniels. Defender number 15, Thomas Mayer Jaguer. Forward number 17, Gabriel Withauper Balbinati. Midfielder number 19, Clement Bahia. Defender number 21, Kamal Miller. Defender number 23, Daniel Kanumbe. And the goalie is number 22, Thomas Hassall. The technical staff for Canada includes Michael Finley, Paul Stolteri, and Nuno Santos. Now the starting lineup for the home team, SEMA Gold. In goal, number 0, Nicholas Hartman. Defender, number 2, Tala Fay. Defender, number 3, Hamidi Diop. Defender, number 4, Musa Gay. Midfielder, number 6, Abdoulaye Diop. Forward, number 7, Miche Engalina. Midfielder, number 8, Usman Sila. Forward, number 9, Pemi Mumbagna. Midfielder, number 10, Atess Diouf. Defender, number 13, Jerzinho Entolo. Forward, number 14, Jeremy Dalalo. SEMA is directed by Mike Potempa and coached by Fernando Arguila Sr. Goalkeeper coach is Iñaki Samanego. Now we ask that we stand for the playing of both national anthems. First, the national anthem of Canada, to be followed by the national anthem of the United States. Thank you. Thank you for being in attendance tonight, and we hope you enjoy the game.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Montverde Academy for tonight's match between SEMA Gold and the Canadian U23 national team. I'm Austin Lyon, joined by Robbie Aristodemo. Excited to watch what we think is going to be a really high-level match between these two sides.
Well, we've got some fantastic footballers on hand tonight. We've got, obviously, you've got Alfonso Davies from the Canadian national team. You've got the big striker up front for SEMA Gold in Pemmy, the number nine. So we've got some real good footballers on hand tonight.
Davies was the third youngest player in MLS history when he was signed a couple of years ago by the Vancouver Whitecaps. This Canadian side has several players who are on MLS rosters.
You know, I think in terms of experience, certainly the Canadians have the edge in experience, but we know that SEMA Gold has got a lot of pace, a lot of talent, and kind of untouched talent. A lot of people haven't seen this squad play, so it's an important game for them and certainly a good preparation match for the Canadian team.
And a fantastic showcase opportunity for this SEMA Gold side. You play well against this type of competition with some of the soccer dignitaries we have in attendance, it could lead to big things down the road.
There's always somebody watching, even if it's a park, down the road. But this is a big game. There's a lot of MLS scouts here tonight. And certainly you've got the head coach of the Canadian national team. There's a few Canadian products on the SEMA Gold as well. So you never know what can come out of it.
It is a cool, crisp evening for soccer. Temperature expected to be in the low 40s as we hit the second half tonight. You and I were talking before the game. You like this kind of weather if you're a player.
I think, just in terms of the speed of play, it's going to be a faster game. I'd rather have this than, 90, 95 degrees. So I think the speed, the tempo is going to be attractive for the fans.
This U23 Canadian side in the midst of a 10-day training camp that runs through January 18th. Play a couple of matches tonight against SEMA Gold, also against Atletico, the side that is participating in the Florida Cup, which is taking place here in the Sunshine State. SEMA Gold, blue tops, blue pants. The Canadian side with the white tops and red pants. What are you going to be watching for here early from both sides, Robbie?
Well, I think there'll be some nerves on both ends. The SEMA Gold certainly training more together for a longer period of time. The Canadian camp just arrived, a couple days together, so it's going to be new for a lot of these players. And it'll be interesting to see how the nerves and the players settle into the game.
The match starting a little bit later than we anticipated because the Canadian side had some trouble getting here. Wanted to make sure that they were warmed up and ready to roll before we got going. Tonight, SEMA Gold putting good pressure on the ball in the back.
Like a lot of athletic players for SEMA Gold. Yeah, again, the number nine, Pemmy up top, is a real threat going forward on the counter.
Pemmy Mumbagna, 17-year-old forward from Cameroon. Knocked over the touchline with Atess Diouf giving chase for SEMA Gold.
And I think the early jitters on both sides. See what type of system they're playing. See what the tactics look like. It looks like both teams are playing with a back four. Most likely a 4-3-3 or 4-2-3-1. We'll see how the game shapes out.
You and I were talking to the coaches for the Canadian side before the match. They were impressed with the size of the field. Felt like it would give a great sense of the talent on both sides.
Well, I think the more space, it certainly allows some of the top players to shine. A little bit more room on the ball, a little bit more time. And again, the surface is great. It's probably 120 by 80, so it's one of the biggest surfaces that these kids are going to play on.
Kamal Miller, outstanding center back from Syracuse. Anchor of the Orioles defense the last 3 years. Sending that one over the touchline. SEMA Gold with a throw in right in front of their bench area. Talafay knocks it back toward the keeper, Nicholas Hartman. Pressure from the Canadian side. Perhaps a scoring opportunity. Crossed. Goes all the way through the six. It's Alfonso Davies, he was talking about earlier, the Vancouver Whitecaps.
Yeah, Alfonso Davies, I think at this point there's a lot of people that are pinning the hopes of the Canadian full team on him, and he's a real talent, he's a gem. He can go both feet, he's got pace, he's got real pace, not just pace, he's got some real pace, and he's very dynamic.
Davies, 9 goals in 26 appearances last year with Vancouver, and just 18 years old. One of the bright shining stars in the Canadian national system.
When you go, Fonzie.
23 side for the Canadians. No one older than 21 on the roster.
Go, 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 go!
Moussaguet, 19-year-old of Senegal, possessing in the back for Sima Gold.
Yeah, Moussaguet, big, strong center back. He can launch the ball 60 yards. He's a fantastic talent. Very composed on the ball for a big man.
Get central engaged.
Senegal well represented on this Sima Gold roster.
Come, Fonzie. Come, Fonzie.
Seven players. We'll see the field tonight from the country of Senegal. Canadians content to knock it around in the back.
Well, you've got Sima Gold that's kind of sitting in a little bit and you know, closing some space down and looking to try to win it and go on the counter with their big man up top, Henry.
Opening 5 minutes here at Montford Academy. At your home on this Saturday night in Lake County for this fantastic soccer showcase. And as you can see on the far side of the field, a very nice crowd has assembled to watch these two sides go at it. Hey, up the near sideline, here's Talafe.
Good, Daniel.
Jeremy Galallo, 17-year-old from Canada, in between a couple of his native countrymen.
A little nutmeg there.
Sam, you got to be an option, Sam. In here.
Spaces.
Fuck, you're going closer to the defender.
Now the Canadian team looks like they've got a back four. They've got, you know, one or two center mids kind of interchanging in there. They collect the ball from the center backs.
Davies with a touch right in front of the Sima bench. We'll be a throw in for Daniel Kanumbe. Yeah. Referee rules a throw in for Sima Gold.
Yeah, kind of like a boxing match first round, just kind of feeling each other out. It's a little bit slow, methodical, trying to figure out, you know, what are the tactics in the game and how we can exploit space in behind both teams.
Well, a few times we've seen Sima Gold with possession on the Canadian side, and will be a free kick.
Well, and there's Pemi. He's the danger man. I mean, he's making a good inside-out run down the left-hand side of the pitch and comes inside and fouled by the Canadians. It's a dangerous spot because there's a few players on the Sima team that can really smash a ball.
Kick will come from about 25 yards out. It's Thomas Hassall, 19-year-old in goal for the Canadians. Three starts for the national side last year. Had a clean sheet in a 2-0 win against Antigua and Barbuda.
Yeah, this is a great spot here for Sima Gold. Looking to maybe bend it over the wall into the top left corner, but it's a great spot for a free kick.
Monty Diop, one of the players that is lining it up for Sima Gold. It goes right into that Canadian wall. It's a cold night. Imagine that feels a little bit more stingy. Nice ball played into space and gathered just before the end line. Canadians thwarted the free kick opportunity, but Sima Gold trying to build something. Diop orchestrating with the ball, and it rolls over the touchline. Throw in.
That's a nice little sting of possession here for Sima Gold. Take the air out of the ball a little bit, look to change the attack.
Come, Fonzie, come, Fonzie.
Galallo attacking the center of the field. Nice lead pass. Turn back to the inside. Canadian defense rallying. That was Shamit Shome, 21-year-old of the Montreal Impact. a player down for Seema.
Dummy!
Looks like Nietzsche, one of the players for Seema.
Dummy!
Looks like, you know, get a tough challenge from one of the Canadian center backs. They got stepped on there. And again, in this cold weather, you know, you get stepped on by some cleats, it's going to hurt.
Referee Daniel Gutierrez making sure he's okay and ready to roll.
Step up!
Yeah, I like the last few minutes from Seema Gold. Kind of settle down a little bit, get a little bit of possession. The free kick certainly helped. And you know, keep that ball in the attacking third of the field.
Nearly 8 minutes in. No score between the Canadian U23 national team and Seema Gold, Soccer Institute of Montford Academy here in Lake County. Delalo gets it to his feet. Davies right behind him and he gains possession.
Steady, Fonzie, steady. Steady.
Delalo, good challenge. Davies in between three defenders. Able to keep the ball going and then loses possession.
Fonzie's got to get the gym.
Diop knocks it back. Nice pressure up top by without for Valvinati.
Great touch inside here.
Lost that fourth ball.
Got away from a little bit, Seema Gold players. And valiant effort.
Didn't hold off the fourth guy on his back.
Bahia got taken down. About to be a Canadian throw-in.
Yeah, it's going to take, he's probably going to take a half for the Canadian team to kind of figure out some of the tendencies. You've got the center back, you know, Kamal Miller, that is probably the only player that's really, really trying to make a name for himself. So he's invited to the camp to see what he can do.
Miller with that big left foot. He had an outstanding college career at Syracuse. Good story as well. He was way behind academically entering his junior year of high school. Really fought to get his grades in order to have a chance to play college soccer. Kanumbe goes down. The whistle comes a little bit late.
Yeah, I didn't think there was
take
much.
Take your time, Matthew. Take your time.
But, not, you know, nothing to really complain about. It's a little bit of a nudge more than anything. But a dangerous set piece nonetheless for the Canadians. They've got a couple big center backs that come into the box and maybe create some damage going forward.
Jam, just stay in there.
Jam, stay in there. Spain.
Quality, hey, quality, Matthew.
Schwenier that lines up.
Daniel, tighter with Caden.
The Canadians. High arcing ball just outside the six. Seema Gold able to get the clearance. Lots of touches on the near sideline, eventually knocked down by Clement Bahia. Making his debut
again
for one of the Canadian national side. Big opportunity for him in this 10-day camp.
We're seeing a little bit more pressure from the Canadians. Come on. Starting to pressure as he starting to create some turnovers. And again, this is something that Seema Gold, you know, hasn't seen that often. Certainly they do play some high-level games, but anytime you play a national team, the pace and speed of play is going to be a little bit quicker. So
come on, check in.
Not going to be as much time on the ball.
Come on, don't force it.
In the middle of the pitch, that's Sila, 16-year-old from Senegal, midfielder. Wicked shot, well, that 45 yards out. Close to being on frame.
Well, it's worth an effort. You know, obviously, I think it's a little bit far out, but you know, it's worth an effort. Maybe test the keeper that's possibly sleepy, but it's going to be very difficult to be a keeper of this type of quality from that distance.
Saul and James Pantemis, the two keepers on the Canadian roster. Saul part of the Vancouver Whitecaps residency program.
Hey, gather! Hey! Hey!
Big right-footed boot over the midfield stripe.
Good, Daniel. Play, play, Matthew, play!
Possession to the Canadians.
Yeah, I think it's a foul from Jeremy, number 14. He's from Montreal, so he's got a little stake in the game here. Prove a little bit to the Canadian coaches and the staff that, you know, give him a sniff, give him a chance, why not?
Delalo, 17 on the hole.
Come on,
play him. Playing up top, Seema Gold. Set up the near sideline. Good opportunity. Here's Schwenier.
The ball.
Kanumbe. And a shot to score for the Canadian team.
Bravo, bravo.
The ball, Daniel.
Hey, Daniel! Daniel!
Side. It was Kanumbe that sent the ball towards the six-yard box and knocked in by Alfonso Davies.
Well, he's the gem of Canada. You know, certainly switched sides, and he was closer to the left-hand side. He must have switched him on the right-hand side.
We don't have to go all the way back.
He made an immediate impact. Great goal, Tim Ball. The post finish from probably the top prospect in Canada.
In the 13th minute, it's Alfonso Davies that opens up the scoring. First call up for the national team came last year for Davies, and again, third youngest player in MLS history when he was signed a couple of years ago by the Vancouver Whitecaps.
Well, the Whitecaps have a gem. I mean, he's from Edmonton, but there's been a lot of talks about Europe, and certainly someone of his pedigree
will
find himself in one of the bigger clubs in Europe in the next few years.
Between the Whitecaps, the
impact. You got it. Well done.
FC, emphasis being placed on homegrown players from the
Canadian
MLS. Starting to see more of those as well.
Well, I love it. You know, and again, you're trying to develop the Canadian players and send them to the Whitecaps or the Toronto.
Don't go back,
you know, TFC, we've got the farm team, TFC2, the Impact have a farm team. Obviously, a lot of opportunity for these young players to continue to develop in professional ranks.
What a great showcase this 10-day training camp is. Chance to get out of frigid Canadian weather. -30 earlier this week up north. And even though it is frigid for someone like me born and bred in Florida, these guys in Canada were walking around with shorts and short sleeves on earlier today. They said this was like a summer day.
This is a beach day for Canada. You might even get in the water in this type of temperature.
That's a white ball. That's a white ball.
I was there about a week ago, you know, Christmas over the holidays, seeing my family. And literally, I couldn't get outside. It was just too cold. Florida has changed my blood.
That's how it is for all the Northerners. They come down here hardened by those cold winters that they've lived through. And you spend a summer or two down here and the blood thins out in a hurry.
Yeah, this temperature here, I'm freezing right now. But you know, again, for a soccer night, it's great. We've got a nice crowd. The field looks great. Both sides have some quality players. It's a fantastic night for football.
He's trying to work that far sideline.
Just roll it in there. There you go.
Another good chance.
Yeah, they're on the
terrific stop
too,
made by Hartman.
It's another end-to-end run from Davies there. Again, it's without the keeper making that save, it's a tap-in. It's 2-0 up for the Canadians. But Alfonso Davies kind of working his magic on the right side of the pitch.
17-year-old Spaniard Nicholas Hartman keeps it a 1-0 lead for the Canadian side. Davies, the goal scored in the 13th minute.
I'm back to the bye
now. Just under 30 minutes remaining in the opening half. Four clearance from the Canadian side, right to Dalalo. Chance to
I think if you look at the goal, it's a great post finish.
I believe that was Miche Angelina.
Nice finish, certainly a nice celebration, but I think the center back from Syracuse, number 21, Kamal Miller, just really giving the ball away too cheaply without any real pressure. So I think he's going to want that one back. And I think a little bit fortunate from Sima, but a great finish and a good little sniff out there with a little pressure on the ball.
Just to show you how quickly things can change. The Canadians had lots of nice buildup. They get the goal from Davies, nearly another one to go in front, 2-0. Hartman makes the save, and then with a poor play in the back, all of a sudden it's a 1-1 game.
Yeah, I mean, it's a game of mistakes. You know, your center back's under pressure. Again, Kamal Miller's obviously for the Syracuse Orangemen, but you know, he hasn't played at this level with the national team, and certainly a little bit of nerves. He's trying to showcase his abilities to the head coach, and just obviously wants that one back. That was just a simple giveaway out of the back.
For a period of 5-10 minutes where each side
come on.
Out the opponent now. A score for each team. That one
good tummy.
Ended up the field by Faye and negotiated by Hassall.
That's a great composed header to the keeper for the Canadian center back. Just calm, cool, collected, nudging that back.
Sam, you need to become an option, Sam.
Center back. Don't you go a little bit. Over Jeremy. Come on.
Coaching staff trying to implore their players to create pressure.
Ponzi.
On the far sideline, that's Angelina. He's got the goal for Sima Gold. And just moments ago.
Now you're in.
Tackle and Bahia goes down.
Be careful there. And it is a game where you're showcasing in front of a lot of scouts, but you don't want to leave your feet with studs up. You don't want anything hurt, certainly, in a friendly. But luckily, the card wasn't drawn there.
Yellow shown by the referee, Daniel Gutierrez. It'll be a free kick for the Canadians.
No, no, but we're not going to deal with those for next.
1-1 our score, 26-53 remaining in the opening half.
Yeah, wow.
Shamit Shome took the free kick. Canadians trying to work quickly. Kanumbe giving chase, and that was well defended by Sima Gold. Musagay in the back.
Yeah, the big man at the back, Musagay, read that well, used his body. It's going to be very difficult to get around him. He blocks a lot of sun.
19-year-old defender from Senegal.
Not a lot of pressure from the Canadians. They're content with allowing the center backs possession.
Diop in the middle of the park. Kanumbe will allow that to roll back to the feet of Hassall. Good contact being made by the Canadian side, able to stay in bounds.
Davies again, inside out.
Loose in front. Bahia couldn't get much of a foot on it. Quickly covered by Hartman. Davies making everything happen for this Canada attack.
Well, at times it almost looks too easy for him, kind of just coasting by defenders, almost like a Messi does sometimes. And, you know, just really smooth on the ball, good dribbler, sees the field. Really been impressed with his start tonight.
Giveaway, Aiden Daniels regains possession for the Canadians. And this one of two matches that the U23s will play during this 10-day camp. Also taking on Atletico, Colombia side, playing in the Florida Cup.
Well, it's a full-blown pro team, so I think, you know, certainly want to rest some of their key players for tonight's game in anticipation that that game may prove to be a little bit more difficult when we're talking about season pros.
Faye plays it over the touchline for Sima Gold, and we'll have a corner kick for the Canadians. Approaching the midway point of this first half. Corner kick over the frame, no harm to Sima Gold. First corner kick of the match comes for the Canadian side in the 21st minute. Again, we see not much pressure from the Canadians when Sima Gold is starting to build up their attack.
Well, I think you also have to look at the time of year. You're talking a January camp. A lot of these players are off season.
Nice dribbling showcase there from Angelina. He's got the score for Sima Gold. I'll call him for a foul.
Damn.
Yeah, you know, I alluded to the fact that just the fitness levels, you know, you certainly don't expect the Canadians to be at their peak fitness. It's a January camp. It's kind of a dead period in terms of the professional sides, MLS, USL. It starts February, March, and it starts to ramp up in the coming weeks. But it certainly is a good building blocks for the next few weeks for some of these youngsters to get ready for their MLS or USL seasons.
Davies has been the man on the attack for the Canadians. Here comes Miller. He had the key giveaway that led to the Angelina goal to equalize at 1-1.
Nice. Well, looked like he settled down as well. He's a left-footed player, likes to play the ball, you know, out to the wide spots. And I think he settled down nicely after that poor giveaway.
He along the near sideline.
Seaman really trying to put high press on the Canadians.
The ball over the top and offside flag up.
And I think that advantage is towards Seaman, you know, certainly training much more consistently over the last 4 or 5 months together as a group. Their fitness level should be a little bit sharper right now than the Canadian team. And I like what the coaching staff is doing from Seaman Gold, trying to up the tempo and press the Canadians a little bit higher up the field.
Saw a glimpse of what that pressure could lead to when Miller had the misplay.
Ref!
A match like this with two opponents that are unfamiliar. We've got a Canadian player down and a foul called. When you don't know what to expect from your opponent, especially as a defender, you kind of have to be ready for anything. The Canadians are seeing a lot of pressure. Meanwhile, the SEMA Gold back line has the opportunity to survey the defense and carry the ball up the field a little bit.
Yeah, not as much pressure on the ball. And again, I think that has to do with a little bit of tactics, a little bit of fitness. The Canadians haven't played together as a group. This is the first training camp that they've been together. Getting to know each other, tendencies, tactics from the coaching staff.
Schoen plays it back in the direction of Miller. Canadian looks to flip the field. Long switch, Mejia, and he was offside.
Beautiful switch, point of attack. You see the SEMA team sliding over to the left-hand side of the field as a group of 10, really minimizing gaps and spaces, and I love that switch of the attack from the Canadian. Just a touch offside.
Moussa Gay knocks it toward the far side of the field to restart things for SEMA Gold.
Push up! Push up!
Miche Angelina has the score for the Soccer Institute of Montverde Academy. Answering the goal by Alfonso Davies, young Canadian phenom. And we are even at one with just under 20 minutes remaining here in the opening half.
Come, Daniel.
Matthew.
For the most part, the Canadians unfazed by
there.
The pressure. There's a header from Fay, 18-year-old defender from Senegal. The ball at the feet of Abdoulaye Diop.
Yeah, I don't think the Canadians are going to be too fazed by this type of pressure. You know, all these players are young professionals. They play either in a B squad for whether it's TFC, Whitecaps, or the Impact. Some of them have got some MLS starts, so this sort of pressure isn't going to be anything surprising to them, but credit to SEMA Gold. They are working hard together as a unit and creating some turnovers.
Restart goes back toward Gay.
Boys, 5 minutes. Just go for about 5 minutes. Just keep warm a little bit. Yeah? It's now, 4 or 5 minutes, so you're not freezing. James, not you.
SEMA Gold content to knock the ball around if they don't like what they see going forward.
Well, if the Canadians are going to give them some time on the ball, you might as well keep the ball. At the end of the day, though, it is a showcase. You want to showcase your players. You're really not playing this game to win the game. It really doesn't matter. It's more about showcasing your players and the talent that you have on the field. So you do want to see attacking football, and hopefully we see that more and more as the game goes on.
Austin Lyon, Robbie Aristodemo, thanks for checking out our live stream here on Saturday night at Montverde Academy. Again, as you look at the far side of the field, great crowd has showed up to watch this fantastic showcase. A lot of contact there outside the top of the box. Finally, the whistle comes.
Just surprised that's not a yellow. That's a goal-scoring opportunity for the Canadians, and actually, it was a yellow. Looks like he's going to pull the card. He has to. Dangerous opportunity here.
It was Matthew Schwenier that was in position to have a chance at a score, and now potentially a free kick for Schwenier. Older brother David also plays in the midfield. Schwenier, three seasons in the Montreal Impact Academy.
He's got a bright future. There's been a lot of talk about him. He's a very technical player, composed, quick, light of feet, and a good dribbler of the ball. Let's see if he can bend a ball here for the keeper in the middle of the pitch.
Hartman between the pipes. That one into the wall. Second chance and a rocket from 30 yards out. What a shot that was.
It happened so quickly, I'm not sure if that was Alfonso Davies again. I think everyone's giving Davies another high five, so it looks like the man, the myth, the legend, Davies here, the young Canadian prospect that as a country we've got our hopes on him. But that was an absolute rocket with, I believe, his right foot, which is, I think, his weaker foot.
Davies has both scores for the Canadian side. Sima Gold knocks down the free kick. The ball ends up on the right foot of Davies, and he blasted it into the upper left corner of the net. No chance for Hartman, given the velocity on that shot. Sima Gold quickly trying to counter, but the flag was up.
Well, it's a world-class goal from Davies there. I mean, the wall did its job, blocked the first attempt, rebound out to Davies. It kind of came from nothing. A little bit fortunate to drop to Davies' feet, but he made no mistake but hitting that ball top left corner.
Davies has shown so far in the first 30 minutes he is a dominating force for this U23 Canadian side.
Go forward, forward.
Well-placed ball as the Canadians advance it up the near sideline. Bahia turning it inside. Nice dribbling exhibition. Here's Kanumbe. A left-footed cross. Ball free at the top of the 18 and claimed by Sima Gold. Out wide to the Canadian Dalalo.
A good composure from Sima Gold getting out of the back under a little bit of distress there.
Keep in there. Keep in there.
Fire up, he sends it back toward Hartman.
Cover, cover.
A little bit more pressure from the Canadians as Hartman knocks it forward. It was Mayor Jaguar on the ball for the Canadians. 21-year-old who was signed by the Impact as a homegrown player in November.
Come on.
Mayor Jaguar was the captain of the U20 Canadian national team in 2016. More space. What a touch! And a fantastic save made by Hartman. Another rebound opportunity just high from the Canadians.
Davies is a real talent. He kind of just, again, almost like he's walking past some of the center backs for the Sima Gold there. But it was actually a fantastic save from the Sima Gold keeper. So credit to him with a nice kick save with his left foot. But again, Davies almost on a hat trick there, walking through.
Makes it look so easy. You talk about athletes at all levels and all sports with those long strides that seemingly are able to cover so much ground with such little movement. That's how it looks for Davies, just breezing down the field.
Been very impressed so far with him. I know he's even got a little bit of an ankle knock. I was fortunate enough to watch a little bit of the Canadian camp 2 days ago.
And
he wasn't training because of a previous injury, but he looks fit and sharp tonight.
He could have fooled me. Some space on the far side for the Canadians. Ball sent toward the top of the 18. And Dalalo will carry it. Nice tackle made.
It's
actually a great tackle there.
That was Schwenier. Now Schwenier out wide. Playing it toward Bahia.
Just a little bit of a spell here for the Canadians. Whipping some good balls into the final third, getting some overlapping runs from their outside backs, and putting a little bit more pressure like as we see right now.
A giveaway and a great opportunity. Shot is high and a little bit wide.
Sima Gold just has to settle down a little bit, get composed, keep things compact. They're getting a little bit stretched out. They're very much attacking-minded team. They like to have their fullbacks really wide and high. So, again, if there is a turnover, those two center backs have to cover a lot of ground.
It was with Alper Balbinati on that scoring opportunity for the Canadians.
Better, come on. Well done.
Speaks English, French, and Portuguese, both of his parents born in Brazil. Dalalo drops it off. Shot from just outside the top of the box. Sails wide and into the hospitality area.
I like the movement from Jeremy, number 14 for Sima Gold, coming from the right, chopping into his left, making a nice square ball across the field. And you know, again, an attempt. Certainly the ball was a little bit wide, but you like the movement from the young Canadian from Sima Gold.
12 minutes remaining in the opening half. Alfonso Davies has both of the goals for the Canadian under-23s. They lead Sima Gold 2-1. Miche Angelina has the score for Sima Gold.
Hey, look at Sima when they are building out of the back. They really stretch their two center backs. Their outside backs really go nice and high, looking to get in behind and creating overloads.
That sails over the head of Talafe. A throw in for the Canadians. Bahia tried to orchestrate something in between three Sima Gold players. Able to maintain possession.
Daniel, where are you going? You give him no option.
Miller with a long ball.
Probably one too many long balls for Miller. I would think the Canadian staff would like to see him play a little bit quicker, a little bit sharper and on the ground, get some of his talented center mids a little bit more touches on the ball.
Diop trying to flip the attack for Sima Gold. We talked at the top of the broadcast about a fast pace you expected because the quality of the pitch, the weather, and I think both teams have delivered on that.
It's been a great match. You know, again, after the first few minutes of the game, you know, a little bit nervy on both parts. Don't know what to expect. Certainly with the Canadian camp, you've got some new players involved and haven't been able to play together all that much. I was curious to see how they would start, but, you know, they certainly look pretty sharp tonight, as does Sima Gold.
Easy to look organized when you have Davies as efficient as he's been.
Well, Davies, you know, again, he is a player that can play three or four different positions. You know, right now he's tucked on the right side. We saw him earlier start the game on the left side, so he can go either way, and he's very, very dangerous and extremely fast.
Dangerous ball back toward the keeper, Hartman. Came out to negotiate it. But Sima Gold not out of trouble yet. Well, good work. Ball headed down and carried forward.
Shoulder, Tommy, shoulder.
Dalalo turning it to the inside. Run being made by Sila. And Galena gets it on his right foot. Shot attempt. No trouble for Thomas Hassall. Watches that sail harmlessly out of play.
It's a little bit ambitious. We're seeing a few shots 20, 25, 30 yards away from the keeper. Fantastic keeper as well. So you're going to have to hit a real banger from that distance to beat this type of quality with the Canadian keeper.
Under 9 minutes remaining here in the first half.
I would like to see the Canadians build a little bit more out of the back, but I think they're sensing that Sima Gold is very organized with their pressure, and they're hoping that the Canadians do play out of the back. But right now, the keeper is just launching the ball, and they're looking to try to win that second ball. Another offside, I guess, is a little bit trigger happy. The linesman, I'm not sure if that was offside, but nonetheless. Got some instruction from Paul Stalteri, former teammate of mine with the Canadian youth teams, and found himself in the coaching staff for the U-17s. Now he's with the U-20s. He may get a sniff with the full team, and is really trying to develop himself as a top Canadian coach. It certainly was one of the best Canadian talents that we've had, playing for Tottenham Hotspur, Mönchengladbach, Werder Bremen. So he's had a great footballing career.
Stalteri on the technical staff for this camp. Once held the record with 84 caps for the Canadian national team, part of the CONCACAF Gold Cup winning side back in 2000.
Yeah, exciting times back in 2000. Head coach was Holger Osiek from Germany, and certainly made history there, beating Colombia in the final 2-0. I can remember those days, and it was a great time for Canadian footballers and a lot of promise at that time.
We talked a lot at the top about the dangerous attacker for Sima Gold, Pemi Mumbagna. Haven't seen many opportunities from him. That shot just wide of Hassall.
It was a great effort there, coming again from a turnover from the Canadian side. It looks like this is the best attack for Sima Gold. It's a turnover on the Canadians. And I think they've got to be a bit more tidy in the defensive third of their pitch and not giving cheap balls away.
Those couple plays give you some indication of why the Sima Gold coaching staff is urging the players to continue to apply that pressure up top.
Exactly.
Bahia and Faye involved in a header. Those two have been head-to-head a couple of times with balls in the air on the near side. Diop wins it.
I think Bahia is kind of praying for the keeper not to stop launching these 60-yard balls in the air, because he certainly is not a big player. He's tidy, he's quick, he's a good dribbler. But you know, these little guys that are technical certainly don't want to be battling in the air.
Sima Gold player took a tumble, and a yellow card shown to a Canadian defender. That is Caden Chung, 20-year-old fullback.
Good opportunity for Sima Gold. It's a good spot, whipping a ball, about whether an in-swinger, out-swinger, but they've got some big bodies, Sima Gold. A couple center backs have some real good size and strength. Good in the air. Maybe an opportunity for Sima Gold to get back into the game with a great whipped-in ball.
Glimpse at the clock, which continues to roll. Under 6 minutes to go in the opening half. Exciting first 40 minutes here at Montverde Academy. Sima Gold trailing 2-1, but with an opportunity to equalize.
Attack the ball!
Dangerous free kick. They decide to go backwards with it.
The Canadians quickly trying to react to the decision to play the ball backward. There's Ingalina. Could not get it through to him. Canadians not out of trouble yet. Sima Gold continuing to apply pressure. Fantastic ball. A shot in the equalizer.
That's the big man up top that we were talking about. Pemi, their number nine, their star player. Poached. Great finish with his left foot to the right side. Nothing the keeper could have done there. It was a fantastic finish. Again, another turnover. I don't think the Canadians had full possession of that ball, but Sima pounced on any sort of mistake, and thought it was a great finish.
Pemi Mumbagna, a 17-year-old from Cameroon, equalizes at 2 in the 40th minute. Sima Gold player who is coming to the bench area. Player appears to have injured his left shoulder.
It looks like it may have came out, which is always disturbing, because you've got to kind of put that back into place. At the moment, it looks like they're going to play a man down, and I don't know if I saw someone go in first place.
No substitute came to the center line. Sima Gold continuing to ratchet up that pressure. Part of the reason they've got both of their goals, creating mistakes from the back line of the Canadian team. A test Diouf with a tackle. And they're going to show him a card.
Hey, get a fucking hold of that. Seriously, man. Come on, that's fucking ridiculous. Fuck off. Fucking hell.
Canadian player is still down.
That's not what you're doing there. Sort that out. Fuck me.
Go. A bit of it's a yellow card. I mean, you know, again, this is the worry part sometimes when you play these friendlies, that you know, the Sima Gold certainly looking to try to gain respect and showcase their abilities. That, you know, the Canadian team is coming down for a camp and, you know, certainly need a game.
Yeah, I did. Yeah. Fuck God.
You know, the Canadian staff out to try to tend to their injured player.
Fucking hell.
D The Oof was shown the yellow. It was the tackle by the 17-year-old that drew the card. Talk
to us. No, it's a card. I mean, you know, certainly there's a bit of ball in that tackle. You know, you have to say did get some ball, but the studs were up. And that's how players get injured, and he's leading with his studs up. Certainly got a lot of ball, but he also got a bit of player as well. So, you know, for me, it's a fair call. It's a yellow card, no question. You know, a bit of bickering on both sides with the coaching staff. But, you know, it's a heated game. 2-2. I think a fairly even game. Sima Gold has pounced on a few mistakes from the Canadians. The Canadians have created a few, you know, probably a few more quality chances in the attacking third. But I think a fair result right now at 2-2.
Chouinard was the injured player for the Canadians. He is to his feet and walking around. So it appears as though he is going to be okay. And Hamidi Diop was the player who was having issues with his left shoulder. He has now returned to the pitch. So good to see that for both sides.
Well, you don't want to see any injuries in an international friendly. I mean, you know, obviously everyone's here to play some football, work on their fitness, showcase their talents. You don't want to see anyone get injured. So, you know, obviously you're going to see some slide tackles, but we'd love to see the players stay on their feet as much as possible.
And good to see a show of sportsmanship there from Diouf going over to Chouinard, making sure that he was okay. Those two with a nice moment before we get back to action.
Yeah, that's exactly it. Sportsmanship is key in the game. And again, they're not trying to win the World Cup here. They're just trying to play and you know, put a good show on.
But moments like that will make the action a little bit more intense.
Well, certainly it always starts with the coaching staff. And once the coaches start getting into it a little bit and they feel like there's a bit of a game and, you know, maybe some tough tackles, okay, then the game on.
Throw in for Sima Gold as we wind down here. Clock shows 1:05 remaining in the first half. We've had a couple of injuries. We'll see about the decision from Daniel Gutierrez. There's added time. Impressive play, right? Front of us with Kanumbe and Mumbagna.
Well, you look at number 9, Pemi. He is a physical specimen. He's big, he's fast, he's strong. He's got all the tools to be a top footballer for Sima Gold.
Mumbagna has the second goal, equalized in the 40th minute. 2-2. Late whistle.
It's got to be a little bit careful, Sima Gold. It's a couple of late challenges. That's a push from behind. Lucky he's not receiving a yellow card there because that's a bit of dangerous play from behind. We don't, again, that's the second tackle on the number 4 here, the Montreal Impact prospect. First with a tough tackle. That wasn't so tough, but it was from behind, so you have to be careful.
So free kick for Chouinard will come from 40 yards out. No time showing on the clock, so we're now at the discretion of referee Daniel Gutierrez.
Yep.
You figure maybe 3 minutes or so of added time. Sima Gold gets the ball toward the middle of the field, trying to build up, and they turn it over. Canadians playing 3-on-3. Missed opportunity out wide. Here is Bahia. He's done some nice things on the left flank for the Canadians. They're a giveaway. And Sima Gold looking to counter.
Wow, this is a one-man counterattack here. Just didn't read it with Pemi, but that was a fantastic one-man counter here from number 6, Diop.
Figured Diop with Pemi on that right side might have a chance late in the first half. There's the whistle from Daniel Gutierrez. That takes us to halftime. Some good things from both sides. 2-2 after 45 minutes between Sima Gold and the Canadian U23 national team. We are going to step aside. It'll be a 15-minute halftime. When they resume the second half, we will be right back with you. Don't go anywhere. 2-2 between Sima Gold and the Canadian U23s.
See the ad. I can't even feel my hands.
I didn't even get the beat in the bar.
Oh,
I did not.
I tried to throw it to the goal and it was like,
I only get two for 3 months.
I haven't even a ball yet. Black. I only get a bunch of
them. Yeah, me too.
I need it. That's the thing. My hands are
freezing. Guys, you see the foul? See that foul right there? The one that hurt that player?
Over there? Did you see over there? That guy was going to get in.
I think we can get the ball.
Teams, please line up and step in front of your respective benches. Good evening. Welcome to Montverde Academy for tonight's feature match between host SEMA Gold and Canada's U23s. Montverde Academy promotes good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators, and requests your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, and or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. Thank you for your cooperation. Before we introduce today's starting lineups, let's meet the officials. The referee is Daniel Gutierrez. His assistant referees are Alexander DeRostang and Abdul Kataney. And now the starting lineup for the U23 Canadian national team. Defender number 2, Caden Chung. Midfielder number 4, Matthew Schwinier. Midfielder number 6, Shamit Shoh. Midfielder number 12, Alfonso Davies. Midfielder number 14, Aiden Daniels. Defender number 15, Thomas Mayer-Jaguer. Forward number 17, Gabriel Withalper Balbinati. Midfielder number 19, Clement Bahia. Defender number 21, Kamal Miller. Defender number 23, Daniel Kanumbe. And the goalie is number 22, Thomas Hassall. The technical staff for Canada includes. Teams, please line up and step in front of your respective benches. Good evening. Welcome to Montverde Academy for tonight's feature match between host SEMA Gold and Canada's U23s. Montverde Academy promotes good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators, and requests your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, and or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. Thank you for your cooperation. Before we introduce today's starting lineups, let's meet the officials. The referee is Daniel Gutierrez. His assistant referees are Alexander DeRostang and Abdul Kataini. And now the starting lineup for the U23 Canadian national team. Defender number 2, Caden Chung. Midfielder number 4, Matthew Schwinier. Midfielder number 6, Shamit Shoh. Midfielder number 12, Alfonso Davies. Teams, please line up and step in front of your respective benches. Good evening. Welcome to Montverde Academy for tonight's feature match between host SEMA Gold and Canada's U23s. Montverde Academy promotes good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators, and requests your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. profanity, racial or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, and/or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. Thank you for your cooperation. Before we introduce today's starting lineups, let's meet the officials. The referee is Daniel Gutierrez. His assistant referees are Alexander DeRostang and Abdul Kataney. And now the starting lineup for the U23 Canadian national team. Defender number 2, Caden Chung. Midfielder number 4, Matthew Schwinier. Midfielder number 6, Shamit Shoal. Midfielder number 12, Alfonso Davies. Midfielder number 14, Aiden Daniels. Defender number 15, Thomas Mayer Jaguer. Forward number 17, Gabriel Withauper Balbinati. Midfielder number 19, Clement Bahia. Defender number 21, Kamal Miller. Defender number 23, Daniel Kanumbe. And the goalie is number 22, Thomas Hassall. The technical staff for Canada includes Michael Finley, Paul Stolteri, and Nuno Santos. Now the starting lineup for the home team, SEMA Gold. In goal, number 0, Nicholas Hartman. Defender, number 2, Tala Fay. Defender, number 3, Hamidi Diop. Defender, number 4, Musa Gay. Midfielder, number 6, Abdoulaye Diop. Forward, number 7, Miche Engalina. Midfielder, number 8, Usman Sila.
Starting the second 45 minutes here at Montverde Academy. Thanks for hanging with us. SEMA Gold and the Canadian under 23 national team, even at 2, Alfonso Davies, the 18-year-old phenom, has both of the Canadian goals. SEMA Gold's scores coming from Miche Engalina in the 13th minute, and then the outstanding attacker, Pemi Mumbagna, delivering the equalizer in the 40th minute. So 4 goals scored between the sides in the first half, and now we start the second 45 minutes, and essentially the Canadians are rolling out an entirely new 11.
Well, you kind of figured that would happen. You know, they have a game in a couple of days, want to rest some of their players, want to see some of their players, and you know, I think that was the game plan, give players 45 minutes and get a nice sweat on a nice cold crisp night. And I thought both sides first half probably had chances on both ends, but probably a fair result. I think the Canadians probably carved out a few better chances, but you know, SEMA as a group pressured well as a group and created some nice turnovers in the final third there.
Seema going with a lot of the faces that we saw in the first half. Diop with that ball sent toward the top of the 25. The Canadians with possession on the far sideline. An offside flag up, as it was several times in the first half of the Canadian side.
Yeah, linesmen are getting their money's worth tonight. A lot of offside, just kind of trickling that line. Seema Gold holding that back four shape fairly well.
Canada going with Sean Hundahl and Mansour Afzali up top. Afzali making his debut for the national team. Knocked away and sent back toward the Seema Gold keeper.
Seema Gold keeper played well in the first half. That fantastic kick save on Alphonse Davis to deny him of the hat trick.
That was when it was 1-0. Nicholas Hartman, 17-year-old from Spain.
Yeah, the Canadians lining up in a 4-3-3 with a traditional holding number 6 midfielder. Number 7 for the Canadians, Liam Frazier. He's at TFC 2, coached by Jason Bent. One of the more decorated Canadian footballers that we've had, and he has had a great professional career. Ended early due to injury, but he's had a fantastic coaching career thus far.
Canadians played the long ball a lot in the first half. What comes
come on.
This situation early in the second half. Again, 2-2 between these talented sides. Great opportunity just inside the top of the 18. Maybe one touch too many, and the shot trickles by Hartman.
Fuzzy, good ball.
Well, that was a kind of a change-up. I think he obviously mishit that a little bit, but finding the bottom right corner left of the keeper. I think the keeper kind of got stunned on that change-up shot there because certainly there wasn't a lot of pace on it. But nonetheless, it was a good 1v1 play out wide from the Canadian. Nice whipped-in ball at the top of the 18-yard box. Composed finish. And a, you know, poor start for the Seema Gold. Never good to give up a goal in the first 5 minutes of a half. But
it was Tristan Borges that scored the goal. Borges, 20-year-old, who plays in the Netherlands professionally. Represented his nation at the U-17, U-20 CONCACAF Championships. Started all 9 matches at those 2 events.
Yeah, a lot of these Canadians have a good pedigree. They've played with the 17s, they've played with the 20s. Now their opportunity to play with the Olympic team. So they've got some CONCACAF games, some international experience, and that bodes well in games like tonight.
So the match has produced 5 goals, 3-2, Canadian side up. Been a good showcase for the fans who have come out to watch these two sides go at it.
Well, this is American football, but we're 21-14. So, and you get a lot of that stink about, wow, soccer doesn't produce a lot of goals, but it's already 21-14 if it's American football. So there's a lot of exciting 5 goals. It's fantastic for a game of soccer.
And that would make it already higher scoring than the entire NFC playoff game that was earlier today between
Fuzzy.
Philadelphia and Atlanta.
Alfonzi, just 15-10. Roll.
Exactly.
Alfonzi, just roll Sean in.
The Canadians have made a couple of personnel changes. We still see Clement Mejia out there, but he has moved to the back along with Daniel Kanumbe.
No, Alfonzi. It was Alfonzi.
Nice tackle on the far side of the field from Seema Gold.
Oh, the big man, Moussa Gueye, there. You know, I love watching him play. He's another offside call from the linesman. Just as I'm about to praise Moussa Gueye for that nice slide tackle, we've got an offside on the Canadians.
Seema Gold essentially playing through the whistle as the ball's knocked around the back. It's Jairzinho Nwotolo, 16-year-old from Cameroon. The Canadian side, U23, certainly more seasoned than the players from Seema Gold. See some 21-year-olds on the U23 roster. Oldest player from Seema Gold is 19-year-old Moussa Gueye.
Well, I think, you know, when you're talking international football, you're looking for the young talent, 15, 16, 17-year-old, like an Alphonso Davies when he first got noticed, you know, from the Whitecaps. And you're looking for a young talent that can come in and develop and turn into a world star. And there are certainly a few far between, but The Canadians a little bit more seasoned in terms of their experience, but Sima Gold certainly have some talents on hand tonight.
And there figures to be even more young talent coming through Sima. News this week that Sima will manage and operate Orlando City's Development Academy program at U15, U17, and U19. Orlando City recognizing that this is a fantastic place to develop young players.
Well, anytime you have a residency program, you have players, young students that are going to school here full time. They're able to train a little bit more consistent, and you've got some culture here that oftentimes is hard to find. You've got players from all over the world, so I think bringing the DA here could be a good relationship between both clubs.
Monser, you got to get that ball.
Just as the premier boys soccer program in the entire country. Sima Gold roster with talent from nations all across the world,
yeah,
including Canada, with 14, Jeremy Dalalo. That's some nice action in the first half. Player knocked out. It'll be a free kick for Sima Gold.
Again, getting a little bit chippy. Nothing too malicious, but number seven there for the Canadian, the holding center mid. Number seven, Liam Frazier, from Toronto FC 2. He's got to be careful because he's on a yellow, and he's kind of in that important spot where he's got to break up play, break up tackle. So he's got to be careful.
Frazier, three seasons with Toronto FC 2 of the USL.
Hey, I'm number four here for Sima Gold. Musa Gay, he's known to probably have one of the harder shots for Sima Gold. And I think a lot of people are saying he should be an NFL kicker.
On the ground and wide of the goal.
I think that was the jinx on the
that's the announcer jinx
because that was probably one of the slow shots I've seen. But normally I've seen him hit some in training, and he's got a real cannon of a shot.
On the right! On the right!
Did not see if the Canadians made a goalie change at the half. Looks like Thomas Hassall is still out there in net.
You know what? It's difficult to say from our angle here. They may have made a change with... Let's see if we can get a number.
James Pantemis is the other keeper.
It does look like it's still 22 in goal.
So Hassall, who had three starts for the national side last year, remains in net. 3-2 lead for the Canadians, 2-2 at the half. Fantastic goal from Tristan Borges in the early minutes of the second half has put Canada in front 3-2. Knocked out a play right in front of us by Afsali.
Tempo slowed down just a little bit. I think, again, when you talk about the Canadian team that's made numerous changes, just sometimes the first 10, 15 minutes of a game seems to be a bit more tactical, a little bit more nervy and slow.
Amadi Diop took the throw in, and then had the ball come right back his way. Aggressive takedown over there on the far side as David Chouinard hit the deck. Chouinard, the older brother of Matthew Chouinard, who was heavily involved in the action in the first half.
A lot of promises for the brothers. They're both tidy technical players, out of the Impact Academy, and certainly both have bright futures for the Canadian national team.
David Chouinard, first player to make the jump from FC Montreal to the first team, signed as an MLS homegrown player in 2016.
Yeah, they're tidy players. They find space. They're quick on their feet. They move the ball quickly. They're good dribblers. They're both good footballers, technically and tactically.
Push up!
Yeah. Sima Gold has not been able to mount much out of the back, and a giveaway there.
It could have been a tactical adjustment from the Canadian staff, wanting to press a little bit higher.
Gorgeous, working in traffic. Nice setup and an easy goal on the backside. First time either side is led by two goals tonight. That makes it 4-2 in favor of the Canadians.
Way to go, Blatzy.
Little number 11 there doing some tidy work on the left side. Composed, back to goal. Making a nice little chop in, chop out, whipped in ball across the frame of the goal, and number 16 for the Canadians.
Keep them up in that high portion
Mansoor
of the park,
with a nice composed
finish. Don't let David drop back in. Keep them high. right?
Playing for Sigma FC, one of the bigger clubs in Toronto.
Mansoor Afzali, 21-year-old midfielder, family moved from Pakistan to Canada when he was 4 years old. This camp is his debut for one of the Canadian national teams, and he's got a goal. A nice moment for him, and it makes it a two-goal margin. Borges with a goal and an assist here in the second half. Sima Gold having to play from behind, now trailing 4-2. Diouf trying to flip the attack.
Some sustained possession is what Sima Gold needs right now. I think the Canadians have been putting them under a little bit of pressure. Take the air out of the ball, get some touches, get players involved, and go from there.
And Galina has one of the scores for Sima Gold. Navigates his way into the middle of the field. It's a Tigmusage. I haven't seen a whole lot of extended stretches with possession for Sima Gold. Both of their goals have come off pressuring the back line of the Canadians into mistakes.
Yeah, you know, again, you would kind of expect that from Sima Gold. They're a team that has been training a lot longer than the Canadians, so I think they're going to be a little bit more prepared in terms of their team pressure. And they created two goals off of that.
Julian Dunn-Johnson seeing action for the first time. Discard of a Sima Gold player in the back. Given away by Antolo.
Come on, Davis!
Here comes Luca Uccello.
Go, come on.
Up the right side. Uccello with good pace. And once again, offside flag goes up.
Overlap.
Well, you like to see the overlap run from the right back from Uccello, but again, offside call again from the linesman. I would like to see the 13 for Canada to go at that left center back or the left back there and see if he can be creative going at players, being direct 1v1.
Interested.
Knocked down by Borges. He's been easily the most active player on the field here in the first almost 15 minutes of the second half. A goal and an assist involved in numerous other buildups.
Well done, big man.
Knocked out of play by the Canadian back line. A throw in the attacking third for Sima Gold.
It was a nice defensive effort from the center back for, I want to say, TFC. I'm trying to track his name down, number 20. Yeah, Julian Dunn there, TFC 2 under Jason Bent's tutelage, his guidance, and it turned into a real good center back.
Push on that far side. And a couple of hard tackles in the first half, given the nature of this match. You would expect the officials to have a quick whistle here in the second half.
Yeah, you got to give credit to both referees. I mean, all three referees have been spot on tonight. I think they've called everything they need to. All the yellow cards they've given have been certainly worthy of a yellow card, so they've done great work tonight.
Cello with a nice change of pace. Tried to fit it into a tight window. It looks like Musa Sima Gold rather made a goalkeeping change at the half. Gabriel Gurgi is now out there.
I do like what Liam Frazier has brought to the table here in the second half, playing as a defensive mid. He can really spray a ball, switching the point of attack. He's certainly getting stuck in on some tackles, so he's done some nice things.
Limited changes for Sima Gold, but one of them in the net with Gurgi getting an opportunity to play. And he's certainly been tested early.
Well, he's been involved in some action. The goal, I think, you know, again, it was placed to the keeper's left. I think he got fooled on the change. A bit of a miss hit from the Canadian, but nonetheless, it was accurate. And I don't think much he could have done with it.
And certainly nothing he could have done on that second goal with numerous players. Come on. Here's a nice ball on the other side. Angelina already on one goal tonight. Gets it to his right foot, and it's just high.
Look, Amici is one of their promising players as a winger, number 7. He's got some pace. He's wiry. He can go left to right. He's very shifty. Certainly one of the players for Sima Gold that they expect big things from in the future.
17-year-old from Congo.
Angles, Thomas!
Bengals!
Only player on the SEMA Gold roster to come from the Congo. Diop with the challenge. All headed over the SEMA Gold bench. It will be a Canadian throw. Showing on the clock. 4-2 advantage for the Canadian U-23s. Diouf aggressively gaining possession for SEMA Gold. The players out on both sides, and that's Pemi Mumbagna upset that there was not a whistle. He felt like he was impeded by the Canadian defenders.
Well, good sportsmanship, both shaking hands, and you like to see that. Again, you're not trying to win a World Cup here. You're trying to showcase your abilities. You're trying to get some scouts interested in yourself. And again, you know, the SEMA Gold, I think they're certainly putting their best foot forward. And
at
stages in this game, it certainly looked dangerous. And I do think the Canadians deserve to be up at this point.
Derek, you got to get up.
Long ball play deep up the far sideline.
That's a fantastic ball.
Knocked out of play by the Canadians.
We're talking about Moussa Gay there with one of the strongest pings that you've seen. That's about a 60-yard ping there, right, basically on a dime there for the right winger.
It wasn't much of an approach on that kick. Just swung the leg forward and up it went. Angelina working his way in some traffic. Diop coming to provide support. And a push will give SEMA Gold a free kick just outside the 18-yard box.
Yeah, dangerous free kick here. I mean, certainly you wouldn't think it would be a goal-scoring opportunity direct. They're probably going to have to whip this ball in, but it's a little bit too far wide on an angle close to the edge of the 18, but certainly worth an attempt to whip that ball in, maybe in swinger towards the 6-yard box with a few players making some diagonal runs.
Diouf and Hamadi Diop are the players lined up over it. Diouf takes it straight into the Canadian wall, and the ball ends up at the feet of one of the U-23s. And officials with a whistle will get a substitution. Omar Cease, I beg your pardon, Usman Garba going to come on. 16-year-old midfielder from Cameroon will see his first action of the night for SEMA Gold. Clock showing just under 26 minutes remaining.
Nice to see some fresh players come in, showcase their abilities to the scouts that are in the crowd. And again, you just never know what someone sees. Everybody looks at something a little bit differently.
Joao Lucas Barreto also going to get a chance to come in.
Oh, the big man, Pemi, with a fantastic finish with the left foot in the first half. Big body, good frame, certainly has a lot of potential going forward, and I know there's a lot of people that really like his talent.
So Pemi Mumbagna heads to the bench. Up. You want to talk about a size disparity there, with that there. Substitution. Mumbagna probably goes 6'2", buck 95, solid. And Barreto is every bit of 5'7", 140.
A little bit of a different type of player. You're not going to get a much hold-up play, but you're going to get a guy that can probably take players on. He's shifty, can find the gaps.
The line with Jules together. Don't drop.
Amazing to see Barreto out there next to Julian Dunn Johnson, the 18-year-old center back, who is probably the tallest player on the field tonight at about 6'4".
Who played that?
Help him.
Barreto trying to pester Dunn Johnson into a giveaway.
Good ref.
A referee, I got to commend the referee. He's done a good job. He's called the fouls that needed to be called. He's pulled a yellow when it's needed to be pulled, and he's really kept this game at bay. You know, there's been a few tackles here and there, but again, that's football. You're going to get some tough tackles in such a talented group of footballers.
Daniel Gutierrez motioning toward the SEMA Gold bench.
Come on, Sean. Come, Sean.
Hey, get away from the ball.
Holds up play.
Tristan.
That could be maybe settle down a little bit.
Come in the hole,
you know,
Tristan.
If you're on the bench, you don't want to get involved.
Let somebody else rotate,
you know, between the lines, you know, just kind of watch and observe, and there doesn't be a lot of bickering towards the referee if there's a foul or not a foul.
Is that how you describe your coaching style on the bench? Watch and observe?
I wish. I wish, you know, at times. But, you know, again, you know, coaches, it's a tough job because, you know, you want to be in there helping your kids out, and ultimately you've got to allow these players to make their own mistakes and learn through developing, making mistakes and
stay high.
You
know, stay
taking
high.
Some hard losses. So you try to be as quiet as you can when the game and the whistle blows.
It's a little bit more relaxed sitting over here than is what you're saying.
Much easier here, I can tell you that much.
A giveaway from SEMA Gold. Canadians already with two scores in this half. And on the rebound, nearly a third. Boy, it looked like for sure Borges was going to have his second goal.
Well, I'm not sure why he used his laces there. He could have took it down, pitched a tent, maybe have a donut, cigar, and walk it in the goal there. He decided to kind of be fancy and lace it in the bottom corner, but just missed.
The first shot was from Luca Uccello. It was deflected by Gergi. And it looked like Borges for sure was going to have an easy one. So it stays 4-2. Another substitution for SEMA Gold. Momar Ndai comes in. 18-year-old defender from Senegal, now managing things in the back. And Ndai involved right away. Makumba Ba turning it to the inside on that right foot.
Come on, sir.
It's taken down, no whistle.
Good.
Uccello. A lot of contact there between him and Usman Garba.
And there's Frazier again with another perfectly pinged ball.
To the inside, there's a chip. That's off the gloves of Gergi. It will be a corner kick for the Canadians. Just past the midway point of the second half. 4-2 lead for the Canadian U23 national team on this cool evening in Lake County.
Daniel.
I really like number 11 for the Canadians. He's, you know, again, he's shown a lot of promise, finding the gaps, a couple real good scoring opportunities, you know, FC Dallas product, but yeah, it shows a lot of promise for the Canadians.
Tristan Borges, 20-year-old who plays in the Netherlands with Sport Club here in Veen.
Come on, come on, come on.
Makumba Ba, unable to settle that one down.
Very impressed with your pronunciation tonight, Austin. I mean, doing a fantastic job with these are the easiest names to pronounce, and you know, SEMA Gold's got, you know, players from all over the world, but you're doing great.
Feel like I'm getting my international dialect part. Training in here, huh?
Yep.
Support.
Never mind. A lot of these Canadians too. You know, you have. There's so many different cultures and backgrounds in Canada nowadays, and you've got players from all parts of the world in terms of second, third, fourth generation. My parents are from, you know, born and raised in Italy, and you see a lot of these players with their parents from different parts of the world.
Think about Mansour Afzali, family moved from Pakistan to Canada when he was just 4 years old. Sean Hundahl, born in Canada to Indian parents. Even though this is the Canadian national team, a number of different cultures represented on the roster.
On the ball, Tristan.
Yeah, there's number 11 again. You know, Borges, Tristan Borges. He just does a good job just finding the space. Yeah, obviously from the Netherlands. I think I got him wrong earlier with the FC Dallas. But for me, he looks the real deal. He looks the part. Nice left foot.
Quality, Tristan, eh? We'll get a chance to see Borges on the ball, potentially with that left foot as he lines up a free kick. Four players on the top of the box, ready to make a run for the Canadians.
Fantastic ball.
Borges looping it in. Canadian player running on and finishing.
I'm not sure if they're calling a foul because it looked to be a goal. No real issues there, but I'm not sure if it's a goal or not. Certainly an injury, but it looked like there was nothing involved in that play.
Gabriel Gergi is down for SEMA Gold. A couple of members of the staff will come out there to check on the 17-year-old keeper from Spain.
Who was it? Julius?
And again, one of the things you talk about in a match like this, obviously everyone wants to showcase their talent, but you want to get out of here injury-free. The last thing you want is to sustain anything serious that will affect yourself going forward in an exhibition-type match like this.
Well, you do have the MLS training camp, USL training camp coming up in a few short weeks, so certainly you want to go in healthy, giving your best effort to see if you can get some minutes. And if you've got opportunity to crack a first team, you want to go in as sharp as possible. And I'm not sure if they're calling a goal or if it's a foul. I'm not exactly sure.
We'll know based on where they put the ball. And based on that, that is going to be no goal for the Canadians. So a foul whistled on Canada wipes out the goal, takes away that brilliant ball played by Borges. So it stays a 4-2 game.
And now, you know, I guess it's one of those things we can ask the referee after the game what the call was. Could have been offside. Maybe it was a little bit quick run from one of the center backs coming in there on that whipped in ball from Borges. But nonetheless, it was a good goal. Even if it was offside.
Cut the line. Inside.
So a player
inside.
Helped off inside. For yeah. Sima Gold. And we get back to action with 17 and a half minutes to go. And again, there is the quick whistle. Player hits the turf. Immediate call from the referee.
You don't need to.
Sure, the Sima Gold coaching staff would love to see a more consistent buildup with their attack.
Easier said than done. The Canadians are really stepping high in their 4-3-3, doing a lot of work and squeezing the field here. It's a great composed play there from the Sima Gold.
Cover, Liam.
Makumba Ba, 15-year-old coming back to assist with the clearance.
Come on, sir, block the line. Inside now, be inside.
Pushed back nearly all the way to their goal line. Wheeling around.
No foul.
All being delivered between three players. Sima Gold on this near sideline. Can't get anybody else involved.
Some great composure from Sima Gold there. I think ultimately a little bit too much dribbling. Allowing the Canadian players to kind of quickly squeeze that player on the ball.
Anderson Rosa going to come in for Sima Gold. 16-year-old defender from Brazil. Amadi Diop heads to the bench.
Good day.
The far sideline was Barreto. 2-2 at the half. Canadian U23s with both goals here in the second half as we come up on 15 minutes remaining.
He's got a lot of opportunities right now for Sima Gold. I mean, nothing really troubling for the keeper in the second half.
Well, right to the front of the six, but no one there for Sima Gold, easily cleared by Dunn Johnson.
This number six here for Sima Gold on the ball looks really tidy and sharp, and crafty.
Abdoulaye Diop, 18-year-old midfielder from Senegal.
Come on, Munster, help him! Good ball.
Bahia keeps the ball well done, on the ground on. As he advances it forward.
Foul.
A double team and a takeaway by Sima Gold. That's Diouf.
Some fresh legs, this is what it looks like. They come in, they can press the ball, squeeze the game, play a little bit quicker, play a bit sharper.
The youth heads it up at the head of three different players before finally settling on the ground. Crafty maneuver by Fraser. That's your guy again.
That'd be a fantastic turn and ball.
Well done, David. Unlucky.
A difficult angle there for David
Schwinier.
See him desperately wanting to get that shot up. Kept dribbling on that right foot. And couldn't quite get the ball where he wanted it.
Well, you got a guy in Schwinier. You know, he's got a cap with the national team. I'm not sure how many times he's been called up, but You know, the staff has seen some ability out of him to give him that call for the senior team. So he's got some ability. But I love the ball from Frazier there. He neatly rolls it and then swings it, switches it. It's a fantastic footballer there. I really like him. Doesn't look like he'd be that technical. He's big body, he's thick. But for me, he's been one of the better players in the second half.
Outswinger, Jules. Outswinger.
Left-footed effort from the far flag. Oh, missed clearance there, and the ball gently rolls into the waiting hands of the keeper. A break for Sima Gold.
Yeah, I just lost their run. That could have been... That's their number seven again. He's got to be careful because he's on a yellow.
It's Liam Frazier.
You know, I think, again, Liam Frazier is the one that kind of... That ball bounced to him in the middle of the goal. Missed that sitter just off of that whipped-in ball. And tracked back and made that kind of more of a collision than anything. I think they kind of just ran into each other. Don't think it was studs up, but certainly he's on a yellow, so he's got to be careful.
Looked like a productive conversation between Frazier and the official. And too much harm done to a test Diouf. Comes to the sideline briefly. Looked like he was going to be fine to come back in. Official on this side, Alexander DeRostang, telling him to wait, and now they'll allow him to come back on. Clock shows 12 minutes exactly remaining in the match. 4-2, Canadian U23s in front. It was a 2-2 game at the half. Borges with a goal in the 49th minute. And then Afzali scoring in the 57th minute. Borges the assist on that goal. He's been involved in both scores here in the second half. Makumba Ba, who's shown some nice things in the second half for Sima Gold. Cello knocked down a foul.
Munster, here.
We'll give the Canadians a free kick.
Quickie. Go, Munster. Go! Go!
Frazier plays it forward for Afzali. Just outside the 18, his cross knocked down. And then dribbled over the end line. So it'll be a corner kick for the Canadians.
Again, there's Frazier kind of starting the attack calmly. And pushes it to his right, slips the ball between the center back and the left back. And a nice defensive play from Sima Gold there, but they've got to defend this corner. Mark up runners and make sure they don't do what they did the last one when they allowed Frazier a kind of a wide open attempt.
Goal. Hey! Well done, Jules.
Chance.
Well done, Jules.
Chance for a header for the Canadian side.
Good,
stop there from Hartman.
Yeah, just you know, one of the things I've noticed, just not marking up on free kicks, corners, as well as Sima Gold should be. You know, it's a free header in the box there, and a great save from the Sima Gold keeper, from the big man from TFC 2, Julian Dunn.
One of the things that a match like this does for Sima Gold is sometimes you play an inferior opponent, you don't necessarily have all your weaknesses exposed, but when you play aside the quality of these U23s, you're going to get a much better indication of what you need to improve.
Well, if you want to grow as a program and you want to be realistic with your goals and ambitions and trying to send players all over the world in different types of clubs and environments, you know, taking a loss is going to be the best thing for this group because they can learn, they can grow, and they can continue to develop. If you continue to win, surely nothing you need to fix.
Go, push up, guys.
Long ball from Diouf toward the far sideline.
Luca, Luca, Sima come on, Luca.
Trying to mount an attack, trailing by two goals with less than 10 minutes showing on the clock.
I have liked a few of the players from Sima Gold that have come in the second half. They look certainly probably some of their younger players, but you know, it looked like they've got a lot of potential. And again, that final third is where most teams struggle in the world. And right now, Sima Gold really haven't had a ton in the second half. Had some decent spells of possession and some technical work, but nothing to trouble the keeper.
You think about the experience that players like Joao Lucas Barreto, Makumba Ba are getting. They're just 15 years old going up against a lot of 19, 20, 21-year-olds on the Canadian side.
No, I agree. I mean, I think there's certainly a few years age gap, but at the same time, you know, if you're good enough, you're old enough. And if you're in Alfonso Davies at 16, he's making his senior debut for the national team. And so at a certain point, age doesn't really become a factor once you start hitting 17, 18, 19. You've got to be of a certain pedigree to continue to move forward in a professional career.
Momar Endai retreating defensively.
Well done, Crow. Derek. Well done, Derek.
Canadians certainly not done. They'd like to find the back of the net one more time.
Movement. Good, Julian.
Dunn Johnson, who's done a nice job negotiating things in the back. Switch to the near side for Bahia. One of the few Canadians who's been out there for the full 80-plus minutes so far. It's about a dozen or so offside calls against the Canadian side.
Well, you're always threading that line. You're trying to make that lines and make that tough call, and I think that was fairly close there from the number nine for the Canadian team. But it's certainly a good inside-out run and just a little bit offside. Good holding line from Seema Gold.
Another positive that Mike Potempa and Fernando Arguila Sr. can take from this match.
Yeah, it's always positives. Scoring two goals was always a positive. Certainly created a few more after that.
Good, Clement. Well done, Clement. Good.
Bravo.
Side note, Potempa, Clemson product, Paul Stalteri, also a Clemson product, be it only 1 year before he moved on to the Toronto Lynx and then made his professional career over in Germany, Werder Bremen, and kind of moved on from there.
Munzer,
but both Clemson products. So yeah,
recover, Munzer! Stuff. Munzer!
Potempa, the director of coaching here at SEMA, number of accolades in his decorated career. First male soccer player at Clemson that was both academic and an athletic All-American in soccer. Excelled both in the classroom and on the field. One-on-one opportunity, and the Canadians tack on another.
Good job. Good movement, boys. Good movement.
That looked easy. A composed finish from the 10. You know, it's a great through ball. It's a great timed run. Again, kind of the parting of the sea for the two center backs for Seema Gold. I think they got a little bit exposed there on the counter. But composed finish and tidy work from the Canadians.
David Choinier, 21-year-old of the Montreal Impact, with a goal in the 85th minute. Three goals in the second half for the Canadian side, and they've now got a 5-2 lead.
Well, I think the score, you know, is an indicator that they've created more chances and certainly shown that in the second half. A couple of composed finishes and a couple
Come
of
on,
near,
sir,
near misses as well.
Come on, Munzer, recover!
Overall, I've been fairly impressed with the Canadian side. They've got some bright players, good future for the senior men's national team if a few of these kids can graduate.
Lucas Barreto trying to thread the needle to the top of the 18. Booted away.
Push up! Jules! Derek! Up!
And giving chase.
Hold! Hold!
Gone. Right in front of the Seema Gold bench. Endai's ball not able to be headed down by Anderson Rosa.
Liam.
Yeah, when Seema Gold attacks, they really like to stretch their
Liam
team.
Now.
They've got their two outside fullbacks playing as wingers, as oftentimes you see with a lot of teams. But again, if you lose it, there's that danger of too much space to be exposed from the Canadians, and they're taking advantage of that.
Up! Derek, up! Up, Derek!
Fraser gives it away.
Now.
Here's Uccello.
Okay, Luke, all right.
Ball just rolled away too much.
Back in, Munzer. Hey, back in. Well done.
Usagay's been out there nearly the full 90 for Seema Gold.
Good, you too.
Big man in the back putting together a quality effort tonight.
All right, come on.
As the Canadian keeper is down. Referee Daniel Gutierrez will check on Thomas Hassall.
Yeah, I think, you know, fair enough to the forward for Seema Gold. I think he was trying to get a little nick of the ball. I don't think it was anything too nasty, but it did look like he probably, you know, kind of grazed his kneecap possibly.
Liam.
But
Liam.
Good composed keeping, goalkeeping there, coming off his line and smothering that ball.
Liam!
Clock shows 3.5 minutes to play. See if Gutierrez opts for a couple minutes of added time. We've had some injuries here in the second half.
Julian.
Diop. Nice ball for Diouf. Seema Gold with a little build-up here. Ball knocked down and played toward the sideline. It will be a Seema Gold throw-in.
Yeah, nice little half chance there. Nice little split ball and whipped in left footer, but cleared away from the center back.
And Galinga.
Jules got a man. Derek, organize.
Seen a gold player.
Get him in, boys.
He's out over there before the end line. Help to his feet.
Yeah, you love to see the sportsmanship. I mean, it's a friendly game. You know, players just want to get a sweat and try to impress whoever's watching and impress the staff. And, you know, it's all in good nature. Be competitive, but
attack the ball.
Be a good sport.
One boy wide open. Set piece chance here for Seema Gold in the closing minutes. Ball from Angelina off the foot of a Canadian player, so they'll get another chance.
Hey, he's wide open. Oh, match up.
Looks like Stalteri's doing a bit more of the coaching here, which is nice to see. You know, like I said earlier, continuing to try to develop his coaching resume, and you know, games like this certainly helps polish that because he's dealing with lots of different types of players and ages and different clubs, and it can only benefit him.
Makumba Ba, one-on-one near the goal line, has it poked away. And for the third time in a couple of minutes,
Seema
Gold generates a corner. And Ba going to play it quickly. Nice work from Diop. I thought Ba was coming with him, left it on the corner of the penalty area, and now a chance for a potential counter for the Canadians.
Go, son. Oh, right in the face.
Chouinier defended aggressively by Talafe.
What about the stiff arm that he took?
That great defending from Tala. Especially 1v1 there on that counter attack. But again, I've been impressed with the Canadians with the change of the attack. Some of their players are really able to pick a ball 30, 40, 50 yards on a dime, and it just showed there another fantastic ball.
Simple!
Fraser with the touch, could not get the ball past Anderson Rosa.
Just roll it.
That's it.
But they keep working, and Fraser, nice ball. Another one-on-one chance. Stopped initially and stopped again. And the threat erased by Seema Gold.
Oh, Sean Hondo there, number 9, with a breakaway miss. Good save from the keeper. Got to give Seema goalkeeper credit.
Well done, Jules. Good, Jules.
But really a couple of breakaways that we've seen from the Canadian national team. I think just a little bit disjointed out of the back.
Jules, check your shoulder!
Bob with a run up the near sideline. No time left on the clock, so we're at the discretion of Daniel Gutierrez for added time. And that will be all. One final chance for Seema Gold. They could not build anything. So the match comes to a close with the Canadian U23s winning it by the final of 5-2. A 2-2 game at the half. The Canadians score all three goals in the second half. What were your takeaways from what we saw tonight?
Yeah, certainly some bright spots on both sides. You know, I think the Seema Gold staff can be proud of their players. You're certainly playing a lot of players. But, you know, they had a few bright moments during the course of the game. But I think the Canadian team deserved to win the game. They created a little bit more chances. And, you know, again, it's an international friendly. Both sides did well, showcased their own abilities and their programs. But bright future for both sides.
SEMA Gold, obviously, with a number of young, talented players. We saw a goal from Pemi Mubagna, saw some really good things from Moussa Gay. A lot to take from this going forward for Fernando Arguila and Mike Potempa.
No, definitely. Again, I told you earlier in the broadcast that, you know, a loss is probably the best thing that could happen to programs. Reevaluate what do we need to get better at and get back to the drawing board.
And for the Canadian side, obviously you as a Canadian yourself have to be thrilled with the prospects of Alfonso Davies based on what we saw in the first 45.
Very excited. Obviously, he's a threat as a winger on the right, on the left. He can take players on both ways. He's composed, hit a cracker of a goal today, and certainly the future of Canadian football, and hopefully he continues to develop and stays humble and stays hungry.
Great night for soccer. Great showcase for all of the players on the field tonight. We appreciate you taking part of it in for us, for our entire crew. And Robbie Aristodemo, I'm Austin Lyons, saying good night from Montverde Academy. Final score, the Canadian U23s 5 and SEMA Gold 2.
Guys, let's go in the next in the gym for a cool down. Let's go, guys. Let's go. Come on.